Why am I making a video about the best brake upgrades? Additional horsepower tends to be the most sought-after upgrade for a car. Suspension upgrades are a common modification too. However, the fastest, best-handling car still needs to stop. That's why I feel that brakes are the most important thing you can upgrade on your car. If you're going to upgrade the performance of your braking system, where are the most performance gains found? Let's take a look at the braking system part by part and find out. Oh, and for this video, we're going to assume that we're dealing with a modern car with 4 disc brakes, an anti-lock braking system, and no regenerative braking. However, if you have a vehicle that differs from this assumption, stick around as the conclusion will still be useful to you. Plus, you'll have some good advice for your friends that drive less interesting cars. Let's start with the brake pads. These are the most commonly changed part on the braking system since they are the wear item doing the direct work in the braking system. The friction material contacts the brake rotor and, depending on how much brake pressure is applied, provides friction that resists the rotation of the rotor and wheel assembly. Not all friction material is created equal, and high-performance brake pads tend to be made out of better materials. However, some of the added benefits these performance brake pads offer are focused on providing reliable braking performance when the pads and rotors get hot. Heat can make some materials more sticky or more likely to lock up, and other materials behave poorly, leading to brake fade. Even if you do get a brake pad that is capable of more stopping power, the brakes are limited to what the ABS system is capable of handling when you are pressing hard enough on the brakes that the wheels begin to lock up. Plus, brake pad material changes are pretty much the only performance upgrade you can get from brake pads alone. You can't put in a bigger brake pad without changing the other parts too. Brake pads, good upgrade, but not our winner. What about brake rotors? Drilled and/or slotted brake rotors trade off a little bit of surface area for better cooling, and some performance brake rotors are made out of better materials that stand up to heat more effectively. Between coping with heat better and getting rid of it faster than stock brake rotors, this upgrade has potential. However, the better cooling performance and reduced surface area contact may change the feel of the brakes. You still run into the same problem where you reach the limits of traction and the ABS kicks in. While they're not the winner of today's video, they are for sure the coolest looking upgrade of the bunch. I like the look of them so much I put them in almost all my cars. What about brake calipers? A big brake kit may substantially improve the maximum potential of a vehicle's braking system, but as with the other two upgrades, what it can bring to the table has limits in the form of traction and what the anti-lock braking system can do. Paired with other upgrades, a big brake kit is going to provide massive stopping power, but you do need those other upgrades, as well as have the room inside your wheels for those bigger parts. Some vehicles have that room from the factory, but others do not and will require some larger wheels to fit those new calipers. So it's not our winner today. Plus, big brake kits tend to either have to be made custom or be a swap from an existing vehicle with bigger brakes and some compatibility. So it's not an option for a lot of vehicles without serious fabrication work. I've been mentioning the anti-lock braking system a lot so far. Is there anything that can be done to upgrade the ABS system? Unfortunately, although ABS unit upgrades do exist, these tend to be pretty complicated and beyond the scope of most DIY enthusiasts. Even if you were to get the absolute most out of an ABS unit by giving it faster, more advanced processors, there are limitations in traction and brake fluid. Modern anti-lock brake systems are already quite advanced, so you're well into the realm of diminishing returns when it comes to braking performance. Some advanced ABS units would require you to upgrade to a lower viscosity brake fluid to have it work properly, so just like a big brake kit, it's not standing on its own as an upgrade. Even when putting cost and complexity aside, an ABS unit upgrade just doesn't make sense as a top braking system upgrade. Brake fluid is often overlooked as a braking performance enhancer. It's a consumable like brake pads, but pads and rotors are where the friction happens, so people almost instinctively give them the most attention. However, if the braking system is being pushed to its limit and brake fade occurs due to the brake fluid boiling, you're not going to get much more out of any other upgrade, not even the winning one on this list, until the brake fluid gets upgraded. If you have a modern car with relatively few miles on it, it's unlikely that this is occurring unless you're being incredibly hard on the brakes. Old brake fluid can also cause this, and fresh brake fluid at the manufacturer's spec may fix that issue. However, if your brakes deal with unusual conditions such as towing or lots of steep downhill driving, and just deal with more heat than what the manufacturer planned for, then a brake fluid upgrade may actually be your best option. Because of that, it's second place on this list. So close. Maybe next time, brake fluid. It may be obvious to some of you at this point, but the best upgrade you can make to your braking system is a good set of tires. The additional grip offered by a better tire will allow you to push your stock brakes harder before they get to the edge of locking up and the ABS gets to work. To get the most grip all year long, that may mean you have a summer tire during the summer and a snow tire for winter if the environment you're in calls for it. You can have the best brake pads, rotors, calipers, brake fluid, and a state-of-the-art ABS unit, but none of that is going to overcome a lack of grip from a mediocre set of tires. If you've ever tried to slow down on a patch of ice, you know just how important it is to have a good grip on the road. Honestly, it's extra great that this is the result because tires also improve handling, and in cases where engines are powerful enough to break traction, improve acceleration too. Nice. Also, no, there isn't a tire sponsor plot twist at the end of this video. In fact, let me know what your favorite tire is in the comments below, and what brake part you think should have taken second place. By the way, if you're now curious about tires, check out this video about how to read the codes on the side of a tire. A lot of people don't know about them, and it can really give you an advantage when it comes to choosing a tire. Thanks for watching.